Hi there, welcome to Bead With Me. I'm Kay, your host from Fantastic Stars Beads in Vienna, Virginia. It's a gorgeous day. It's a little under 90. We're not totally sweating it out, but it's still a perfect day to get a chance to come in and play with me for a little bit. How is everyone doing? Welcome, welcome. If you're new to Bead With Me, this is your place for inspiration, motivation, and whatever is a surprise coming in through Stars Beads door. And right now, this week, it's been pearl. So we've been doing all sorts of different pearl designs and showing them off. And yesterday, which I technically didn't have enough time to make the other one, but eventually, this is what we made yesterday. So if you didn't join us, these are some of the projects we've been doing here. Let me show them off while we are getting people popping online here. So we made these pair using these mesh component parts, and then these rocking pieces that we're going to be showing off on this Friday Night Live, some of these new laser cut stainless steel pieces, all in different styles, and then just reviewing working with pearls in general and all different designs that we can, you know, certainly throw them in. We've got them in my bracelets, and here's the earring a little bit more up close so you can see us playing with pearls. And then let's see, pop that around. And then, you know, I love interspersing them in all your leftovers. So remember that it doesn't take very many pearls to make up whatever. So you can use them in everything. So we will be showing off all. So for Friday Night Live, get excited. Okay. So anyone who's new, don't know what Friday Night Live is. What that is a shop till you drop marathon of whatever it is that I find interesting and want to highlight. So this week we are going to be showcasing pearls. We are going to be showcasing some other things as well. So there's going to be a lot of fun pearls that I've been showing, like here this week that have just arrived. I'll be showing off some new colors and messing around with those. And so that's why we've been playing with pearls all week. So I'm sorry, my phone is going crazy, and I thought I had it all set and ready to go, but still technology isn't always on my side here, as we have known, right? Part one, part two. So let me say my hellos, because I always love seeing who's out there, who's joining me, and if you are new, let me know where you guys are coming in from. Oh my gosh, we had people from all over. Yesterday, I think we had like a Vivian, and I think she was from pretty far away, and then we always usually have little Miss Patty from California, and Michelle from Barbados. Let's see who we have online here today. Hello, Miss Amy. Hi, Susan. Hello, Anthony. Good to see you. Carol, it's been a long time. And Marjorie, we've got you on there. So hello, hello. So today, I thought we'd play around with, guess what, pearls, right? Okay, so I know a lot of you guys might have those hoops, right? Those kind of those plain hoops and in just plain silver, plain gold, and simple, right? And sometimes we're looking to get those a little bit more exciting. And so I thought I'd show you a little thing of what we do to those hooks and to those hoops. Today, you know, I was looking for my old hoops, but you know, remember we were actually, you know what? Let me go grab them, because then you can kind of see the idea here. Because I think we have... Remember, we were highlighting Miss Leedy Levendale, and I was wearing, they're a little bit bigger than I wouldn't necessarily use, but so that you can get the idea, okay? So remember, I was wearing these beautiful hoops, right? And so oftentimes you see these hoops in silver or gold and just plain. They are small, they're big, they're large, and sometimes they're a little boring, right? So you want to doll them up a little bit, okay? And the easy way to do that is just add a little dangle, right? And so as I was making the rest of the tassel here, I was thinking, hey, this would be a great idea. So was going to use one of these. Okay, we'll go ahead and use one of these. But what you would want to do is literally, it can be it. Do you have those leftover earrings? You know, you can make that into a charm bracelet. But so if you have a bunch of these laying around, you can make up a bunch and slide them on, and you can add as many as you'd like. So you can do tassels, and I was going to show you some earring parts that you can do that with. Okay, so one of the ideas is, if I was going to do it on this, I'm looking for a bead that would be big enough, but we'll do this for visual effect. Okay, this is probably, I don't know, maybe a little bit bigger than you would want it, but so I'm going to just show you the thing that you would want to look for is how big you want this loop to be if we're going to dangle something off the bottom of it, right? So in this case, actually big pearl, big hoops, okay, that works out good. I'm going to show it to you in a much smaller design here, and I don't have my bail making pliers. I think I want a bigger loop than this, but we're gonna see if it works. Okay, so I've got a nice big loop, and I'm gonna show you going the other way. Hello, Miss Donna. I got your package. I gotta go over to the post office to pick it up since I don't have normal hours here. Okay, so I made a big loop here, and the idea is you want it to be big enough to go over this, and in this case, this is not big enough. Okay. Which is why I would have used a bale making plier so I could make a big one, but don't have one sitting here. So whatever hoop you have, you know, they might be small, they might be big. Okay, so that kind of fits on there. Okay, and then let me get this rounded out here so that it looks like a normal wrap. And then we're gonna go ahead and just wrap this closed, and then we're going to show you what this looks like on there. And I don't have enough wire here, so I'm going to use my plier to finish the wrapping job here. Okay, and cut and close that off. And it's the same way you would do to make a charm or whatever. You just want this loop to be big enough so that it can go over your hoop. And then I'm going to show you some different ones, different earring components that you can do that with. But this is a great way to use up sometimes your old school hoops. Okay, let's see if I can, now I might not have made that big enough. But this isn't perfectly round, so that's not helping my cause here. Okay, but let's, I'll just do it on something else. I need an even bigger one here. All right, I'm gonna use here. I'll use a tinier one, okay? And then we'll put this on there for the effect. But if you have those hooks, okay, that you're gonna slide in, and I really like this one. So this is an interchangeable one. Idea is still the same. Obviously this hoop is now huge, but we can get the idea here. I'll put a smaller one on here. Here, I'll take this one here. And we'll do a mini one. This was gonna go on the bottom of my tassel we made yesterday, but that's okay. I'll do an extra one. All right, so I just made a little mini version here. You could do this with stone, you could do this with whatever. I'm gonna show you a couple different components that make earring making so fast. Okay, so you just slide this right on there. So if you have any hoops, you can totally just do that, and boom, you've got yourself a sweet little earring. Let's show it to you on me and see what you guys think here. All right, so this makes it interchangeable, which I really like this hook in general anyway. So take a look here. Can we see it? Can we even see it? All right, I'll shut. Super sweet. Maybe I'm gonna flip this around. All right, so when we're looking at it from the front, and you can add, oh, you see my wire is sticking out, but that's as easy as it is. Super super easy. Okay, so if we had, like I said, if we had these hoops, okay, you know, you have those, you know, big silver hoops from like high school, and I do, and then you can hang whatever it is you want. So let's show off a couple little designs here that you can do that with. So you could, I had this one sitting here. So this little ball, when you make it small enough, would prevent it from coming off that one side. Okay, that would be the smart way to go. But we're just making fun. And then you can find whatever, it pretty much just needs a loop. So whatever it is you want to hang off of there. Here we're going two-tone, so we can go like a skinny mini and it looks cool from the side, right? You could even put a little tassel. But you could put a little tassel on there. So here's one already on an earring hook, but I'm gonna just change it out. And you can see how easy it is. You could put a little tassel on there. So that whole idea is very, very easy to use. You can put metal, you can layer them. So you could do, okay, so say we like that pearl and then we want that and that tassel, you could totally just do both. These are short though, Rachel. You can see that these ones wouldn't be so bad.
But I understand what you're meaning. Look, if you do little short ones, which is, so on big hoops, you would do maybe small ones, and then on a tinier one, so these little components you can see, you can layer them on. Let me show you. I have an interchangeable lever back here you can do that same idea with. So they don't have to be large hoops. But someone had just come in. So this is a lever back, and you see how it has that dip there versus a closed loop? This is another great component to put whatever it is you want onto an earring. Super quick, super easy. Okay, so maybe you don't like this particular component, you can do the same idea with these interchangeable lever backs. Super easy. Aren't those nice? That wire's bothering me. I gotta tuck it in. All right, now we can show it off. So we've got a couple of style of lever backs that you can do this idea with. You can, like I said, do it with old hoops that you have at home. We also have this style component. So this lever back, it would be the same way. So this is gonna open up. This is where we could put that big old one here. Okay, and then it's just gonna hang on the bottom. Okay, so these ones here are gold filled and sterling. So if you like those, these are interchangeable. We'll do the small interchangeable lever backs and the large ones. And these are ranging, the smaller ones here, if you like them, are running about $6 and $8 a pair. The larger ones here are running like $12 and $16 a pair. So if you like those, it's a cool way. So it's not closed like these ones are. So see how most lever backs are closed here? Let's see if we can zoom in on that so you can see most of the time they're closed. Okay, the difference making them interchangeable is that hoop there is open, or you can see that there's, you know, no ring. Or now I have these ones here also. These are a nice lead and nickel free silver plated. I don't have gold in right now, but I have some silver. So I think you get, they're like $1.25 a pair. So they come in a pack of two pairs if you like those. Oh, and then I found this guy. This is a great new component too that had come in with that other stash. They didn't have a chance to show it to you. But I thought these would look good on there too. You can just slide, so any charm you like, you can just slide it on there. But this one was pretty. I think that one's on backwards. But it makes it quick and easy. Look at that one too. So I love these little components. So interchangeable earring components. Okay, Patty, I'm reading yours. I would like a pair of the gold crystal components and gold open leverbacks, two pairs in the smaller size. All right, I've got that. The crystal component, are we talking about these triangular crystal components or are you talking about these things? You know, I was also thinking if you have those, you have those rondelles. Let me see if I have these big ones. Oh, I don't think they're big enough. But if you have these rondelles too, I know you guys always like the sparkle. These are another good thing to stick onto hoops. I had these jumbo ones. I was going to see if they fit onto here, but nope, they're still, that is just too big. Okay, so you could also do something like this. Again, if you had big old hoops, which I don't, I'm going to just pretend here. I'm going to just take a piece of wire for visual effects since. So you could certainly make your own hoop too. These longer ones. Okay, Patty, I don't think I have them in silver, but I'll get you what I have. But if you had your own hoop, we'll just pretend. I think you can make a little loop here. Alright, so I'm just gonna pretend I'm making a little earpiece just so we can have a pretend hoop. So you could make your own ear wires like this too, I guess. But the idea is you could also slide these on there. I'm just messing around, you guys. Okay, and where's my pearl? Maybe we could stick a pearl in there for fun. Maybe we'll do... I'm just making this up, but you know, so if you were making up your own, which I can't do that. All right, too long. So I'm just messing around. So that you guys can get the idea of when you are hanging something off, you can totally see how it ends up looking. When you're just stringing those things right on there. So you can just string them onto any hoops, any interchangeables. Yeah, I like these triangle ones too, Rachel. Hey, Rachel, I have your little snag bag. Check your messages. I think I'm trying to mail those to you. So check your email. All right, guys. Fun project. So project time is over. What a fun day. So if you want any... If you want the triangle crystal parts, I can do those too. Just put that into the comments and we'll add those to your open box for the week. I'm missing an earring here. Feeling naked on this uneven here. All right. Happy Thursday. Give a like if you like today's feed. Give a share and pass it around. And enjoy the rest of your Thursday, you guys. It's a beautiful day, and we're busy making. And you still have, what, almost 48 hours, not quite, I guess 24 hours to get into win. So I'm going to be giving things away. So I don't know. I was thinking, I was doing decoupage wood, but I was also thinking about giving away some of the
a pair of earrings from Lady Levendale, and I also had some of these. I wanted to give away a pair of these too, so maybe we'll save those for next week. These sweet pair of earrings. And so if you guys are watching for the first time, I'm giving things away every single week. And so on Friday Night Live, which is our marathon sip and shop, a fun night of playtime of beads and deals, I'm usually giving things away. So all you got to do is be creating and post it onto Stars Beads, tag us, and that is your entry to win. So if you want more entries, just got to post more. That's it. You have big competitors out there, you know. I'm trying not to let Nicole and Sherry Lynn win this week, because I realized that happened. But they were posting a lot, so what can I say? So get in to win. I want to see what you guys are making and share it with the world, okay, you guys? It needs to be a little bit more colorful. It's a crazy time, and we need to beat it out. So calm the chaos, y'all. All right. Oh, Beth, happy birthday. Ooh, it's going to be an extra big cheers for you, Beth. Might have to stick a little something in your package there. So, all right, Amy, it looks like I see you're in for some triangles. I'll put some away right now. And I don't know, maybe you guys want those crystal posts, because I need to make these other pair of earrings. I'm still deciding on these posts, you know. We could have put them on these interchangeables too. Let's see. Look, could have put it on that too. Right like that. Boom. That would be pretty. So if you missed yesterday's episode, we made a beautiful little tassel. Pearl tassel, y'all. All right. Have a good rest of the day. And I will pop on. Remember that Bead With Me is now Monday through Thursday, but I'll hop back on to get you excited for Friday Night Live. Okay. But we're not going to be doing a project. I can only handle five days a week. Okay. So thank you so much for all your support. I am grateful to have you guys, and you guys inspire me just as much as hopefully I'm inspiring you guys to get on creating. So have a great rest of the day. We will see you online for sure at 8 p.m. tomorrow. So get into win. I want to see some posts between now and then, you guys. Have a great day. Thank you.